Yeah, so when we're talking about driver design, I mean, the ultimate goal is longer and straighter. That's what everyone wants. Some want a little longer, some want a little straighter. And we want to deliver both at the same time. So how do we do that? How have we done that in the new G driver? It first starts with trying to save weight so we can create higher moment of inertia, move center of gravity to use to our advantage so we can hit it longer. So the primary way we've done that in the new driver, G driver, is Dragonfly technology. So we've created a thin crown casting down to 0.43 millimeters, something that previously I don't think has ever been done before to go this thin. It has a very strategic web structure to it. This allows save 8 grams from the crown. So with that weight savings, now we can position more mass low and back, move the center of gravity lower and deeper, boost inertia, so off-center hits are even more stable than the G30 driver. So how do we get it to go longer? In addition to that, we create a more aerodynamic shape. So the face-to-crown transition has a little bit more doming to it. We still have turbulators on the front, as the G30 did. This helps reduce some of the unwanted wake behind the back of the driver. We still have a little bit of that at the back end of the driver, though. And so we've gained inspiration from a technology that shreds the vortices. So it's called a vortex shredder. And the technology, that's what this small cavity here is on the back of the driver. It takes the small vortices that are creating a little bit of back pressure and smooths those out. So not only does it reduce the drag on the driver, it also creates a more stable flow on the entire downswing. So you can swing the driver faster by about 1 mile an hour in club head speed. So those are the two big technologies that add it all up together. We're able to allow players to swing it faster, to hit it further, gain more forgiveness so their miss hit stability is a lot tighter.